Hi, I'm Johan. Welcome to my channel. This one is going to be a bit different. I have been sick for half a year, 7 months. Actually I've been not feeling well past 3.5 years, but that's another story. So I was thinking about what I can do with the truck when I didn't have the strength to get down to the truck. So I started with the CAD again and started my 3D printer and printed out some parts for the truck. So I started out with this one. And this is a brake fluid holder with 4 compartments in carbon reinforced nylon, and then it's epoxied on the inside and outside. But then something happened. I printed this key. It's for my snowmobile, and it's a paused print where you stop the print in the middle and you place the key in and you start the printer again. And it has 450,000 views on my short channel. That's pretty good for being me and being 3D print too, I think. So then I thought, what can I do to incorporate 3D printing more into the truck? And well, I started doing a lot of things. These are available for download for free. You maybe don't need one with 4 horses. I have one for 3 horses. That are for a master cylinder and a clutch, a hydraulic clutch cylinder. And I have one with 2 horses for a normal master cylinder and one just for the clutch. These lids are from a common European drinking bottle with the heated straps on. So you can't lose it, but you can also print out the lid if you don't have access to that one. When you epoxy this, it's has to have the clearance for the lid, so it's a bit fiddly to get it right. Thank you. And I also have these ones, the adapters for the master cylinders to the hoses. The idea with this one is you can actually mount it on the tubes like this and tap the drill and mount it that way. I made this protractor. It has the center line radius of 7 and 4 inches, and you just print out your tube sizes that you have. You put it in on your central lane radius and cut away the rest. You also cut away these tabs and you measure it from this border. And it's between 0 and 180 degrees, so it's pretty big. It's also for free. And you can actually print out two of them and you can clamp them together. When you're doing the main hoop, you're actually having the right degrees in your hands. I'll be doing some bending for the body panel to be mounted on. So I made myself a protractor holder that you also can print out. When I'm going to cut the tubes for the headers, I want them to be cut straight, so I made these ones that I mount on my miter saw, so I get the cuts straight and good. And also I made a box for my rear steer. It's having spaces for 7 relays and 2 switches, and you put in a wire into it. And this is sitting on the steering hub on the rear axle. So it's a self-centering steer box. So you flick the switch and it goes one way and you release the switch and it goes back to the middle. And I also made a fuse box for this truck. And it has 12 fuses and also 7 relays if I want to. And all the pins are click-in pins, so it actually stays in the 3D print. Maybe your power tools are Makita, and then you have a holder for your batteries. It's a 1, 2, and 3 holder, and a holder for 3. Or you can print out a cookie cutter. Perfect for doing gingerbread snacks. It says Monster Race on it, and it's 2 monster trucks.
Monster race, here it's roar, roar, roar. Sitting here and dreaming about winning over Thor.
Your result can vary a bit. Mine did. Or you can print out a mic holder, of course. It's a bit fragile, and I will make one that for DJI's mics too. I made this coupler between the power glide and the drop box for my very big gears. Also, I'm going to mount my batteries, and I also have worked with the hydraulics a bit more, so they're going in really soon. That should be a fun part. That's all for this video. Hope you liked it, and if you did, put down a like or a comment. And if you're new here, why don't you subscribe? It's free and it really helps my channel. So I see you in the next one, I guess. Bye.